Hello again. In this video, I teach you the absolute basic of HTML and CSS to get you started. A web page in HTML is consist of series of HTML elements, and each HTML element made up from HTML tags. The HTML tags can make a bit of content into a hyperlink to link to another page on the web, italicize words, and so on. HTML used to tell your browser how to structure the web page you visit, and an HTML document is a plain text document structured with elements. For example, I want to create a paragraph on the web page and add my full name into it. I could specify that is a paragraph by enclosing it in a paragraph element. An element may contain a data item, or a text, or an image, or perhaps nothing. A typical element includes an opening tag, includes a text content, and a closing tag. Each tag begins and ends with angle brackets. Also, there are a few empty or void tags that cannot include any text, for instance, image tag, that the end tag's name is preceded by a slash character. And in blank elements, the tag doesn't need the end tag and is not allowed. For example, I want to display an image into web page. So I create an image tag and pass image URL into it. In the image tag, the SRC is an HTML attribute, and I'll talk about it in the next section. HTML without CSS is not beautiful. CSS is used to style and layout web pages, alter the font, color, size, spacing of your content, create multi-columns, add animations, and other decorative features. CSS allow you to create great looking web pages, but how does it work and how does CSS affect HTML? It's a language for specifying how documents are presented to users. When a browser reads a style sheet, it will format the HTML document according to the information in the style sheet. For example, I can change a paragraph text color to the red by using the CSS style sheet. A CSS comprises of style rules that are read by the browser and then affects the HTML elements. A style rule is made of three parts: selector, property, and value. The selector selects an element or many of elements that you want to change the property values. For example, I want to apply my CSS rule to all the paragraphs or images in my HTML document. This could be any tag like paragraph or image. We will learn more about it in the basic of CSS section. A property is a type of attribute of HTML tag. We can change all the HTML attributes into CSS properties. They could be line, color, size, or anything else. And the value is assigned to the property, such as a color property can have red value. There are three ways to inserting a style sheet: external style sheet, internal style sheet, and inline style. And we will learn more about it in the basic of CSS section. Now we know the difference between HTML and CSS, and we have basic knowledge of their syntax. In the next video, we'll finally get our hands dirty and we create a basic HTML document and decorate it by CSS.